Leave it to Beaver.
Well, whenever we cook inside, Mom always says it cooking. But whenever we cook outside, you always do it. How come?
Well, it's sort of traditional, I guess. You know, they say a woman's place is in the home, and I suppose as long as she's in the home, she might as well be in the kitchen.
But how come you always do the outside cooking?
Well, I'll tell you, son. Women do all right when they have all the modern conveniences. But us men are better at this rugged type of outdoor cooking. Sort of a throwback to caveman days. Hand me those asbestos gloves, will you, Molly?
That is exactly how women were portrayed in the 1960s. For many years, women have been fighting for equality with men in the workplace, as well as being treated fairly in society. In the era of the 1960s, 28 women began to make a voice for themselves by creating the National Organization for Women, with the help of Betty Friedan. Music is a huge platform to speak up about social issues, and that's exactly what women in the music industry did to make people listen, think, and change how society labeled women. Starting with Aretha Franklin, which is a household name everyone knows and loves, is predominantly known for her hit song, Respect. Aretha Franklin's 1967 smash hit may seem like a pretty piece of soulful fun, but at the time it came out, this song about a crumbling relationship had more than one meaning. On the one hand, it was the perfect pop song, energetic, catchy, heartfelt, and sexually suggestive. On the other hand, it was the perfect song for the political movement. It was the voice of a strong black woman demanding respect and showing her power. Its thrilling and familiar chorus spelling out respect quickly came to mean something much larger. In Aretha's hands, the song became a fantastic feminist statement. Of course, last U.S. Top 10 hit, You Don't Own Me, is considered one of the many artistic works that helped begin the women's liberation movement. This song is one of the very first in which a woman demands her independence from her man. The original intent was to write a song with a woman telling her man off, "Don't tell me what to do, don't tell me what to say." Though it was soon realized at the time that it would become a woman's anthem, it definitely was the intention to have a woman make a statement. Alongside Gore and Franklin is the equally talented country artist Dolly Parton with her song, Just Because I'm a Woman. 1968, Dolly Parton addressed the sexist double standards women faced with the title track of her second solo album. Just Because I'm a Woman was an anti-slut-shaming anthem before the phrase slut-shaming even took hold in mainstream media. Aretha Franklin's 1967 single, Do Right Woman, Do Right Man, encourages men to respect women and treat them as equals instead of using them. Last but not least, we have Nancy Sinatra with These Boots Are Made for Walking. You keep saying you got something for me. Described by one critic as perhaps the finest kiss off in pop history, this song always had a special place in the hearts of women everywhere, especially when it comes to their dealings with certain kinds of men. And now someone else is getting all your best. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you. These four amazing women really paved the way for music today. As you can see, their music has been so influential that people like Melanie Martinez use snippets or sing covers of these wonderful woman-driven songs. Because of women like Leslie Gore and Aretha Franklin, we now have this amazing melting pot of strong, brave, independent women who speak their minds and speak freely about how confident and self-ruling they are. Since the 60s, women really came a long way in music. But without that foundation that grew and grew as time went on, women in music would probably still be singing about that poor old Johnny boy that she loves dearly. With that said, we're free to sing and speak about whatever we please, and to remind people not to mess with us powerful girls. All in all, the 60s really shaped what music is today, especially the women empowerment, which was, and is, needed to wake the minds of intolerant, opinionated people in this world, and to say, hey, I'm a woman and I can do anything you can, maybe even better.